Good morning, cultists. Welcome back to another Unbalanced Breakfast with Cthulhoops. We are continuing our war in India to take over what is probably some of the last two independent realms in the world. Oh, somehow we managed to take over that thing. Well, I guess it was all thanks to my vassal who is still holding on to his king title, but hopefully not for long. So right now we have an invasion CB for a huge chunk of their lands. Not all of it though, because we don't have a subjugation CB, so we can't really use that until we pass on our realm here to our children. Last episode we had another genius son pop up into existence, Jez the Second. So I'm hoping he can replace Jez the First, who is a little bit of a disappointment. Although she herself has a quick son, so I guess that's kind of the benefit of having her there. But that being said, I was really hoping my sons would catch some kind of disease and just die. But they're doing a terrible job of it. They're just not dying. Like, I don't understand. I give them the best years of my life. The least they could do is just die for me when I ask them to. Man. Parenting is hard, guys. Holy shit. I found a brand new appreciation for my parents, myself. Why do these guys struggle so much in sieging stuff down? Is it just because they don't have enough troops, or what's the dealio? And why do they make my voice go so high-pitched? I have no idea. Now, I think we're going to try to take as much land as we possibly can from this one invasion. But that being said though, I get the feeling that we probably won't really make it that far. No, the Maharashtra we can just ignore. And then we'll just actually focus on the other counties that aren't part of the Maharashtra. Oh, so that actually does include that. Okay, great. And remember guys, you only need to siege down the top holding. You don't need to go for the whole thing. I know what they say, go for broke or whatever, but it's all good. Oh shit, son of a bitch. Can you cancel? Retreating? Son of a bitch. You rat monkey motherfucker. Shit. Guys? Kind of an emergency meeting there. Thank you. Holy shit, this is gonna be... Oh god, down to the last wire. Oh, and we lost. That was like the first battle we've lost in like a million years, of course. Because if you look in the dictionary and look at defeat, you will find no mention of Judaism in our world here. What is this garbage? Okay, she built a monument to herself. You sack of shit. How dare you take like 5,000 ducats and you make a statue to yourself. You asshat. And by that, of course, I mean to say that I'm going to skin your ass and then turn it into a hat. That's the only meaning that could be derived from the phrase asshat. Let's just crush their armies. Man, these guys are fairly strong. Never thought they'd actually win a battle against me, but there you have it. They actually won one battle against me. Never again. I mean, I'm not counting the whole part where I accidentally retreated. That was stupid. And by stupid, I mean the game was being stupid. In that I should be able to cancel my retreat orders if I want to. But the game won't let me, so... Not much I can really do about that, though, can I? Why Jerry Seinfeld? I don't know. I have no idea. Yes, kill shit, take their stuff from me, and then kill more shit, rinse and repeat. You know what, let's get some more mercenaries all up in this hizzy. Fantastic, 16,000, come on in. And once you guys are here, we'll just hire more people. It'll be great, it'll just be like a giant mercenary orgy. Minus the sex. So it'll be nothing like a giant mercenary orgy. Now if you could go over there, take care of that nonsense. Because again, guys, I like the hustle and the, you know, the backbone that you're putting into sieging everything down, but you don't need to go that far. We just need to siege down as much as we can. Or, what am I talking about? I have no idea. I've literally blacked out in the middle of my sentence. And I just kind of woke up just now. I was like, my mouth was moving. Shit was coming out of my mouth, but somewhat literally. And now I'm realizing that maybe I should just think about what I say before I say it. Possibly? But where's the fun in that, right? Bori, you're a sack of shit. Learn stewardship. What's happening over here? Okay, you're making your strides, great. I want you guys to focus on that kingdom. Are you guys good to move on to the next kingdom yet, or no? Not yet. Okay. This is going decently. You're taking some hits, taking some losses. But hopefully, not for much longer? Because we have reinforcements coming in, guys. Just a little heads up, we have reinforcements coming in. And oops, did I just dismiss and then rehire someone? It's very possible. I may have... Yes, I believe I have just dismissed and rehired someone. It is my bad, as one would say. We lost our advisor, why? Why did we lose our advisor, guys? Can anyone tell me what happened to our last advisor? Did he get eaten by a goat? Because I will accept nothing less. What the shit? Why aren't you guys dead? I told you to die. Yet you continuously defy me. Thank you. Now you can eat shit and die in smallpox land. Daughter. You too. You? Sir? Please? Thank you. And, here, why don't you proselytize in this completely inconspicuous place that is not at all rife with any kind of disease whatsoever. Please take out these small smatterings of troops. Thank you very much. And that's a couple more places, and then we should be good with that kingdom. And then you can move on to, I guess, this area just to help out, because we definitely don't need to focus any of our effort into this one. And then we'll have to move on to the southern part later. Great. So are the mercenaries replenishing themselves, or what's the dealio here? Our manpower is recovering ever so slightly. And emphasis on the ever. Or would it be on the slightly? I don't know, whatever. Holy shit, we just lost a shit ton of troops there. That's insane. I don't quite understand what's happening. Am I just actually losing a lot of troops to sieging? Is that what's going on? Does anyone know what's happening? Because I'm very confused as to why we're losing so many troops, like, so often. Take care of them, please. You guys should be able to handle this easily. Atta boys and girls, possibly? I have no idea. I have no idea if these guys are like the modern Israeli army with a mixture of both men and women. I'm assuming so, because we have, you know, full status of women, which is absolutely unprecedented and completely not at all, true to the times, but it's my game. I get to play it however the hell I want, and I wanted to play with, full rights of women, so there. Why don't we get you guys merged in with one of our other stacks? That way we're not just wasting resources and efforts here. If you could take care of those guys on your way, thank you very much. Greatly appreciated. Atta boy girls. Atta people. I think that's the appropriate expression here. Now why don't you guys split off? You guys can go there. Fantastic. That is I think almost that kingdom entirely sieged. Why don't you guys move up there, actually, and move down there. Thank you very much. And we are well on our way. We're gonna have to deal with that, though, so that's gonna be interesting, I suppose. Can we get any of these guys? Little bit? Okay. Great. You guys could all just get all over there. But unfortunately, we just demolished everything. Oops. Demolished everything else that could provide us with the ship, so... unfortunate, but oh well. It's all good. Now, I'm actually going to make sure I don't lead troops, because in case there's some kind of rampant disease going through this area that I completely just neglect. Fantastic. Oh, wait. These guys are there too. Great. So why don't you guys help out and do what you can. Oh, wait. No. Okay, great. You just need to go to the coast of the Maldives. Got it. Guys, what the hell, man? I sieged that down earlier. Don't siege it back. That's so rude. Unacceptable. You guys can move down. Guys, I just wanted to let you know that I appreciate everything you're doing, and I will give you a bonus in your next salary? Wage? I don't know how this system works. I'm assuming you guys are being paid somehow, or compensated, or at least something, right? It's not just like, y'all are doing it for the sake of the world? Maybe? Maybe they are, I don't know. Maybe they're truly extremely selfless and just want nothing but the betterment of their realm and their liege and all that shit. That's part of where we're sieging down, so I don't think we need to worry about that. So let's make sure that we have all of this taken out. Thank you very much. Absolutely just wonderful progress we're making here. Guys, what the hell, man? You know what? Actually, you can take that. I don't really give a rat's ass. But we're gonna try to take you out. I don't know if it's gonna be possible, considering that these are mercenaries and not, in fact, our own troops. Because our own troops are impossibly strong. Whereas the mercenaries, nah, not so much. Fantastic. Great, so you guys managed to take them out, which is great. Except now, that's not gonna work out. You guys are too weak to handle that. Oh, wait, we didn't need to siege that down. Great. You guys should be able to siege that down in a couple weeks. Do I give a shit about what you do? Do you really want... oh, sir. I didn't even know you existed until you did this. Oh. Oh, sir. How unfortunate for you. How very, very sad. So very sad. I literally did not know that guy existed until he brought it up. So, it's on him. It's really not on me. I'm not the one with the maniacal desire to rule the world here. He's the one that's like,
hey, not part of the Empire. Feeling a little left out, guys. Can you include me in all your fun and activities?
I'm just giving him what he wants. Hey, man, don't look at me like that. Don't look at me like that. You'd do the same if you were in my position. Possibly. I know Christopher Walken would. Because he's just the type to do everything that I do. Maybe it's because I am Christopher Walken? No, I wish. I wish I could do Christopher Walken's voice. Everyone knows how deep and passionate the love between one of the courtiers and his wife are, but sadly, it has not resulted in any children. I've heard the wife asking the other wives about cures and ways to get the child, or get with child, but to no avail. I should tell them? No, I'm gonna ask him about his impotence. Oh, what the hell? Why did you lose an eye? Was that part of your battles or something? Or did you just decide to...
I don't need my eye anymore.
I don't know. You never know, right? She's the daughter of a lunatic. She may as well have inherited the trait, right? You never know. Fantastic. Things are going quite well, I gotta say. Knock on all of the wood. So much wood is to be knocked on. Thank you very much. Can you catch those guys, please? They're giving you a right runaround, and we are on horses. So it's a little embarrassing to be outrun by dudes on foot. If you could siege that down, thank you very much. Oh, look at that. We have another daughter. You are also Jez. Fantastic. I'm just gonna name all of my genius children Jez. Until the end of this playthrough, basically. Until, of course, a Jez actually takes over. At which point, I don't think I need to keep naming them Jez. Now, where do we have Slow Fever? Yes. Please. I desperately need you to go talk to these people over here. That would be amazing. Just the best. Thank you. Absolutely fantastic. Now, you guys are almost done there, which is great. You guys move on down, and we're probably going to get attacked here, which is... Oh, you know what? Oh, look at that. I actually managed to catch him. Holy crap. Bori, I don't really give a rat's ass about you. So you can go suck an egg. If you don't want to go suck an egg, I don't know. Go suck something. Don't bother me about it. Right. Wait, was there... Did I just get some notification about an uprising somewhere? Quite possibly. Where is this nonsense? The Hindu uprising? Well, that should be close to home. Great, well, we can deal with that in a second. What is happening over here? Is that being sieged down? Guys, that's embarrassing. Just pull the plug. End his suffering. He's got a cool little hood on, though. He kind of looks like a... You've ever seen those photos on Facebook of, like, cats or dogs stuck in, like, arm sleeves? Like, you know, like, hoodie sleeves? That's kind of what he looks like right now. I just can't get that picture out of my head. He's a cat or a dog stuck inside a human sleeve. I think we actually have... Oh, wait, no, that's not true at all. We still need that. And then we still need this. So, this... How many troops can you hold? You can hold 7,900. Okay, cool. What the hell am I doing leading troops? I told myself to go home and just, I don't know, Netflix and chill with a wife. But apparently, I'm not gonna listen to myself. I don't take no shit from nobody, including myself, apparently. You guys could just really scooch on over there. That'd be great. And if you could siege that down, like, in less than a month, that would also be great. Let's just bring everyone over. What's happening over here? Oh, right, they're being sieged. Got it. But I think otherwise... I apologize for the rapid flashing. I'll try to stop, thank you. You guys could... make your way over. And we lost Dragon. Of course. Dragon... You disloyal fuck. Just when I need you the most. You decide to go and die on me. Unacceptable, Dragon. Unacceptable. And I think we'll siege that down. I'm just gonna do a double check here. Make sure I didn't miss out on anything here.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's everything. Let's see how this turns out. Holy shit. This is looking beautiful. Holy shit. We just have this one little county over here to take over. You're actually not a bad character. I would like to make you an heir? Possibly. But that's not gonna happen, is it? Probably not. That's okay. You're destined for nothingness. Can we take care of this rebellion, please? That's a little embarrassing. It's a little... little mark on our otherwise flawless complexion. Invasion of Lanka? Is this gonna be it? This might be it. This might be the very last non-Khazarian land in the world. I could be wrong. I'm hoping I'm not. Not 100% yet, though. And of course, we have a lot of vassals still, you know, faffing about. So we need to deal with them ASAP. Although, once we're done with this, I think we can pretty much call it a series. Did we do it? No, we're not gonna consider this done until we deal with this nonsense here. I don't care about what you refused, alright? Who's dying? Who's making weird dying noises? If you're gonna die, can you please die quietly? So I'm not disturbed by your deathage? Thank you very much. Where's this French liberation revolt? Unacceptable. Come on, French. Don't do this to me now. Don't do this to me. I just need everyone to just cooperate and die. That's all I'm asking for. And sons and daughter, why the fuck are you still alive? Guys, I told you ages ago to catch disease and die. Yet here you are, still clinging on to life. Look at how many of my siblings died to infected wounds, to cancer, to leprosy, to great pox. Why can't you follow in their footsteps and just die when I ask you to? Absolutely unacceptable. Okay, great. Fantastic. Thank you very much for being useless. Yay. Should we actually revoke all this? I don't think it's completely necessary. It might be fun. Although I can't really revoke his shit because we have a truce with him. And I also can't imprison him and then do that thing that I do where I just, you know, wreck his shit afterwards. But let's take some of these duchies at the very least, so that our land looks a little bit more presentable for our final zoom out, if you will. Great. Please. What's this stirring up of peasants? Don't stir up the peasants. No. I don't want the peasants to be stirred up. Stir them down, if anything. Shake them, not stirred. Oh snap. That joke was made, and I regret it immediately. Why the hell do we have a truce with them? You look badass, sir, with your eye patch, but we're still gonna need your duchy, nonetheless. Now, we still have a lot of, like, county level dudes. What is this, court physician? You're great, but I don't want you right now, because I want my children to die. We just have this guy. Can we imprison you? I'm gonna say no, he's gonna, like, raise a fuss or whatever. But, you know what? I think that's it. It's not all Jewish, unfortunately. But that's just going to be, like, a lot of waiting around, which I don't really want to subject you guys to. But, look at that. 95.9% moral authority of the Jewish faith. That's insane. And look at that. My beautiful face in each of these holy sites, and we've restored the third temple. We have created the kingdom of Israel, or kingdom of David, I believe, which isn't actually called the kingdom of David, but whatever. And we are slowly but surely incorporating the entire world into the kingdom of Khazaria. Have you seen a greater sight? The answer is no. You have not. I couldn't believe it. Holy shit, we actually did it. It's just kind of like... I'm still having a difficult time processing it, but... We actually achieved world domination, guys. This is incredible. Because when we first started out the series, it was all just intended to restore the kingdom of David, but then it just kept snowballing. And when I realized how powerful we were, I realized that we can actually accomplish world domination. And so here we are. Holy crap. I'm not gonna lie, guys, that was quite the journey, and I'm actually quite proud of where we ended up. This is incredible. Jez, I apologize that you haven't had a chance to rule yet, but there are three incarnations of you. And I promise in our next series that you will be our first heir. Possibly. I can't guarantee that, actually. So, but I'll try to make sure that you are our first consciously decided upon heir. And in speaking of next series, I think I'm going to play as a Visigoth Muslim. And I'm not going to reveal the title of the series just yet, but hopefully you guys will join me again for that one, because this was a lot of fun. I mean, the pilots, I feel like it got a little long in the tooth, and I do apologize when I got a little salty about various bugs and game mechanics that weren't working out, especially things like the whole negative manpower thing. That was a little confusing, but then again, I don't think the developers had ever intended for anyone to be able to accomplish world domination, which is why they put a lot of restrictions in this and that, but holy crap, we actually did it. We have avenged the persecution of the Jewish people upon the world, upon the medieval world, at least. But I don't think there was a strong Jewish presence in, like, Asia and whatnot, so... Maybe in the future, a DLC? Who knows? But, in case you're wondering, oh, am I going to, incorporate or, import this into EU4? Possibly in the future. I've tried EU4 a few times. I tried to really get into it, but there's something about EU4 that just really doesn't grip me as much as Crusader Kings 2 does. Because the way I see it, EU4 is like an empire simulator, whereas Crusader Kings 2 is a dynasty simulator. You play as a character and you pass on your lineage and whatever, whereas in EU4 you're playing as like an kind of as a concept almost. You're playing as an empire, right? So that's... I'm finding it's not nearly as entertaining as Crusader Kings 2 is. And we'll celebrate this occasion with Passover. Perfect timing. Holy crap. But yeah, thank you guys so much for following the series. I know there are a handful of you that just keep watching every day. Every time the episode goes up, I can count on at least 50 of you to just immediately jump on the videos, and I want to thank you guys so much. I want to thank Bernard Karp especially for helping me with all the Jewish customs and knowledge and whatnot, as well as you, Torquilles, as well as you, buddy. But yeah, I want to thank you everyone for watching and following, leaving comments, leaving likes, and yeah, hopefully you guys will join me again in the next series of Crusader Kings 2. So, yeah, I don't really have a speech planned, but I'm hoping that that kind of did this justice. I plan on doing a little post-mortem thing, which, in case you're new to the channel, I do a little post-mortem. I want to do a post-mortem thing after every Crusader Kings 2 series, where I basically go through all the leaders in the resign screen, and just kind of like, you know, just walk down memory lane and all that stuff, so... yeah, I don't want to sound like a broken record, but again, thank you guys so much for watching and keeping up with everything, and for everything, honestly, this support has been tremendous, and it's just amazing. And actually, as of today, we have hit 300 subscribers to the channel, so thank you guys so much for your, like, incredible support, and I hope to see you guys again in the next Crusader Kings 2 series, if not... Maybe another series in the channel, which I really recommend that you guys check out, because if you guys like my sense of humor, then maybe you guys will enjoy those other series too. So, thank you so very much for watching, and have a great breakfast.